Hello, and welcome to this Paychex Special Edition video podcast. I'm Rob Parsons, and we're live on the floor of HR Tech 2024. I'm here today with Nathan Shapiro, Head of Platform Strategy and User Experience at Paychex. Nathan oversees a diverse team responsible for shaping Paychex Flex, the company's HR technology application. He champions technology solutions that promote human connection and independence. Nathan's emphasis on collaboration and accessibility has enabled his team to thrive in a rapidly evolving tech landscape. Nathan, thank you for joining me today.
Thank you for having me. It's great to see you again.
So it's a lot of energy here. We're at the opening night of the show. There's a lot of buzz. There's a lot going on. What are you hoping to see in terms of trends here at the show this year?
Yeah, good question. I think AI is inescapable. We're going to see a lot of AI. But what I'm really looking for is who's taking AI and making its use practical to the workforce for productivity, for engagement. There's so much opportunity there, but there's a lot of buzz that's just buzz and no substance. And so when I look at who's actually taking these rapidly evolving capabilities and packaging them in practical ways, not just dropping a text box over an off-the-shelf LLM, that's really interesting to me. And we saw some emerging last year at the show. I think we're going to see things go to the next level this year, and I'm really excited to do that. And I'm really excited to also exhibit how we're doing that to meet small businesses where they need to be.
That's great. So it's interesting you bring up small businesses, because typically small businesses have not been served with enterprise-level technology, enterprise-level solutions. Are we going to see any of that at the show floor? Is that kind of a Paychex domain?
Yeah. Well, obviously, our founder founded Paychex because SMBs were underserved in the market. And, we've done a lot. I think we've really helped turn that as a company. But it's still something where they're not necessarily getting what they deserve and what their employees deserve. And so that's a passion of ours, is bringing enterprise-grade capabilities down market to the small business. And that's, packaging them in a way that's useful to a small business. Their data set is narrower. We have a massive data set to surround them with and give them things like benchmarking that a small business on their own couldn't do, whereas a large enterprise can do some internal benchmarking. So I think we're going to see more of that at the show. I sure hope we do. We like a competitive market. We don't necessarily want to be all on our own. And challenge is good. So I'd like to see somebody step forward and challenge us on that front.
Excellent. Now, a lot of technology, a lot of the evolution, at least from what I'm seeing, driven by the changing workforce. New generations coming in with new expectations, millennials, Gen Z. What's your take on what's happening with the workforce and how technology is responding?
Yeah, it's a great question. I think I'd broaden it. It's more than two generations. There's five in the workforce today. And I'd actually say that, the importance of HR technology and benefits goes to the sixth generation and the future workers and earners, because of how the current workforce is going to set them up for success. So I think what we're seeing there is, number one, there's kind of this like overlap and pull towards each other generationally, where we may have seen certain generations resistant to something, other generations are forcing them to start to at least embrace to an extent. And we're also seeing demand for the most diverse set of offerings and benefits, from traditional benefits like health insurance and retirement, to lifestyle benefits, to technology that can be used digitally to really further human connection in a digital world. And that's fascinating to watch how that's developing. And it's a challenge. I think it's a challenge for all of us. I can tell you my UX team certainly is challenged in going beyond the user type thought process to the individual. And what is the difference in a Gen Z payroll administrator versus a Gen X? But that's a fun challenge. And if we do it well, we're really going to put great solutions in everybody's hands for today and generations to come.
You're in a unique position with the UX team to really tell us what it means to be a digitally driven HR leader. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, I think I'd emphasize the importance of digitally driven versus digital. We have a tendency to think digital means humanless, digital means only engaging with technology, and to an extent, digital can mean isolation, and that's not what we're saying. We're saying digitally driven in everything we do. So that does include providing digital products to our customers and digital products to our internal workforce, but that also means using our big data, using our automation capabilities and finding opportunities to free up the workforce to engage in different ways and go beyond that. It also includes monetizing our data in new ways and finding new products to go to market that might be to totally different customer groups. So I think it's fascinating. I think John Gibson's done a great job pushing us in the direction where we're all data hungry and we're all data stewards. And that's at the core of being digitally driven. And I'm really excited about the trajectory we're on.
It is absolutely an exciting time at Paychex right now. It's very exciting. So I want to pull a quote from your LinkedIn profile.
Oh, boy.
Technology today should be practical, useful, and enable access to solutions that benefit people. It should drive independence, not isolation. It should connect people, not replace them. How does Paychex and even your team balance automation and data and AI with the human element of connection and communication and actually being engaged with my coworkers and in the mission of my company?
Yeah, it's... I'm going to go back a few years. We run what we call design sprints. We've adapted from the Google model, and we started doing it years ago. And when COVID hit, we had to adapt and figure out how to do that in a virtual world. And it used to be stickies on a wall and a lot of in-person. And we adapted that. And what we found was we actually got even greater connection because people who may have been a bit more introverted in a room were able to work together in a remote way. And it's one example. And so when I think about automation, when I think about AI to synthesize massive data sets, really what I think about is how am I freeing up time from repeatable tasks through technology to allow me to engage in human-human tasks and more human connection. And that's really important. You know, I think of myself, if I could find a way to automate 5 minutes of my day, that's 5 days in a work week that I could go and spend five more minutes with a random coworker that I might not get to engage with otherwise. And I think that's really important that not everything has to be massive events. You know, we can still connect in a virtual way, but it's human and human to human. So, you know, I think that's something that's pretty cool. I think the other thing is technology has the ability to unearth insights that may have been difficult for you to otherwise get to. How many times have you looked through a LinkedIn profile of somebody you know, you've talked to numerous times, and all of a sudden realized they went to your alma mater, right? And so when I look at how technology can start to unearth those connections that you can then engage in a very human-to-human way to strengthen a bond, that's pretty powerful, and that's where I look at it. It's not a replacement, it's an augmentation. And that's really how we try to embrace it as well.
That's a great answer to a not an easy question. I don't know that everybody has the right answer to that question.
It's a tough one. It's a tough one. And you have to sometimes step out of it because the threat of my job is being replaced is real. The truth is your job is changing, right? And really, if done well, in positive ways, you know? And so that's kind of the way you have to think about it. We really, when we launched our chatbot back in 2018, there was some fear from our customer service reps that it was going to replace them. And we went on a big evangelization campaign to explain this is actually eliminating the repeatable, simple things so that you can focus on more complex tasks to help your customers and strengthen that bond and relationship with your customers. And, you know, once we kind of got eyes open to that, it was really powerful where they were detractors were coming to us going, this is so great. Can you have it do this? Can you have it do this? And I think once you kind of understand that technology is there to help you be better, it's something you can embrace and really, really accelerate ahead.
I love that. And it's a great way for us to pivot to Paychex. The solutions we're offering, we're bringing some great products to market. We have some really exciting products to show this year at HR Tech. Can you give me a quick highlight of what we're doing in this space to enable our customers to do what they do best?
Absolutely. I'll hit on a couple, and then after that, you got to come to the booth to see the rest. But I think our new Engage product is a great example. It has a ton of awesome features. It has the ability to digitally engage for recognition and rewards, peer-to-peer, you know, manager to employee or down. It also has this really cool hierarchical goals feature. And so we may think about goal tracking, and that's a I have individual goals. But it allows you to do those at the company level, down to departmental levels. And, you know, I think about our journey to $3 billion and how the company rallied around that goal. And people really engaged with each other in different ways to figure out, okay, how can we do this? How can I contribute? How can we contribute? And that's something you might not think of in goals, but when you can do it at that level where a group of people can come together to connect at various levels of the organization, that's really powerful. The other one that I think might be less obvious is our new recruiting copilot, which is an AI-powered recruiting tool. And it's all around multi-channel sourcing and using a unique 3D data model to find candidates. But when you step back from, I have a vacancy that I have to fill, and you realize that you can use a tool like this to go find hundreds of millions of passive or non-job seekers just to get them into your company network and ecosystem, that's a really powerful way to develop human connections with people that otherwise you never would have met. And so, you know, when you look at our solutions, we talk about this a lot, don't just use our solutions in the obvious way that you'd think, our time tracking. We talk about using some of our surveys and performance management to do pulse surveys on server efficiency, for example, as opposed to traditional annual performance reviews. Our application's flexible to meet your needs, but you also can be pretty innovative and think outside the box. And when you do, there are some real gems. And those are things I'm proud of.
That's great. And I want to talk about innovation a little bit. About you, your team. Flex can do a lot. There's a lot of solutions. There's a lot happening. How do you keep it simple? How do you keep it digestible? How do you still make it so it's usable?
Yeah. It's a great question. I don't want to say too much because you got to head over to John Diello's Tech Talk tomorrow on UX secrets for choosing HR tech in the modern workforce. But I'll hit a couple things. I think one, in user experience and product at Paychex, we do build UIs, we design UIs. But really what we do is we craft experiences. And that goes way beyond the user interface and that goes way beyond the application. We think about how are our HR business partners going to engage with a customer around it. We think about how are our customer support reps going to support a customer. We think about all the user types and persona in the business and what do they need? Why would they use it? Right? Those are things we do, and we have a lot of practices around, you know, co-design and usability testing and interviews. But that's really powerful. I think a lot of companies just take a chat interface and slap it over the top of an LLM and say, here you go, AI. And what they fail to think about is who is going to engage with that and why are they going to engage with that? And is the person that's going to engage with it understand prompt engineering? Because if they don't, you're probably actually putting something in their hands that makes their job more difficult,
right,
or risky. And so it's really important to put yourself in the shoes of the end user and try to think through it from that perspective. And if you do, you can come up with really practical ways to do really innovative things. And innovative is not always just new ideas. It's application of an existing idea in a new way. And that's something we're always challenging ourselves with. You know, we get in a lot of discussions, collaboration discussions, where somebody will say, if it could just work like this. And all of a sudden we'll go, well, could it work like that? Is there anything in the market that would allow us to do that? And we'll go out and explore. And you know, I think that's something you have to do. Challenge yourself. Be opinionated, right? When you use something and you don't like it, think about why. Think about how it could be better. You know, bring your personal views to the table. You got to be willing to be challenged on them. But if you can do that, you can really break through some areas and drive some really great solutions into people's hands. So
that's tremendous. And your team is doing just that, Nathan. We're also very proud of everything you do. It's great. And we can see the evidence right behind us on the screen. Thank you for all the work you and your team do. And thank you for joining the podcast today.
I really appreciate you having me. It's a lot of fun being here. So thank you.
Thanks, Nathan.